Digital Mudra is an interactive installation where participants make gestures into poems and poems into gesture dances. Spontaneous Western hand expressions had been photographed in a previous performance, and for this piece, they were correlated with the mudra gesture language of southern India. After starting with the mudra gesture, and I had 34, of course there were over 500 mudra gestures, but only 34 correlated, I got a list of words from those gestures. And from that, I sent that list of words to many artists to create a poem. And that is what started this interactive installation.
It makes a strong cross-cultural statement and involves the participant, the viewer, in getting them to use their own creativity to create a poetic phrase.
Digital Mudra is composed of 7 stations. During the first 3 stations, the participant remains a spectator, and during the last 4 stations, the spectator becomes a participant. At the first station, a videotape, Mudra in a Western Context, shows Kathakali dancer Kunaraman performing poems created from the mudra word list. The second station consists of photographs of people. They're expressing their emotional state with their hands. These photographs are overlaid with transparencies of similar mudra icons, a glossary in the format of a poem, the source material for the installation. Moving to the third station, a larger context comes into play. A slideshow of the mudras are juxtaposed with figures making similar gestures drawn from the newspapers and Sunday comics. The basic vocabulary of the mudras becomes a social dance in which cross-cultural correlations of hand gestures and their trans-cultural meanings are demonstrated.
More than anything, I was fascinated by how some gestures seem to be universal, while the others seem to be very cultural. For example, when I say I'm happy, I do that. Whereas some of the happiness is, people say I'm happy like that, it's not something that's natural to me.
At the fourth station, the spectators become participants by selecting 3 mudra word cards to make their own poetic phrase.
There's something very touching about that process. And you start off, to begin with the exhibition. Well, I don't know if I want to get involved. I don't really like all this stuff. And then you slowly but surely sort of get drawn and sucked into it.
Yeah, you just tell me your poem and I type it in. And then the 3 mudras show up on the screen.
This phrase is entered into the computer at the 5th station, where the participants see their mudra choices dance on the screen.
It does look like a dance, doesn't it?
Yeah, hers is very close.
You're off and rolling.
Oh,
so that's what you're gonna get for your printout.
So your thing is out.
They receive a printout and visit the philosopher at the 6th station. Here, they receive an epigram by the sage Rabindranath Tagore.
How did you come up with this thought? Was this just a thought that you came, the first 3 cards you grabbed, or was there
I have a skin problem.
You have a skin, I see, you have a skin problem, I see. All right. So we will check with the computer.
Look for the cure.
Okay, we will find, I think, that the center of this thought is your skin and that you would like it sent away. We will see what he says about sending your skin away.
May I reach within myself the one which is all, leaving the outer shell to float away.
There you are. Now you can go actualize that on the mudra wall.
At the seventh and final station, the participants find golden aluminum duplicates of their mudra word choices and hang them on the mudra wall to be presented as temple writings.